family worship. We're so glad that you're here. Did you know that the priorities at our church are to gather, grow, and go? Well, this week, as we start the third chapter in 1 Corinthians, which is Paul's letter to the church in Corinth, we are going to be talking about growing. Now, we're not talking about growing up or growing taller. What we're talking about is growing spiritually this week. And that means growing in our faith, growing in knowing Jesus, and growing to love him more. So before we get to our story though, we are going to gather together for worship. So will you worship with us?
Don't want to drink formula for the rest of your life. No, of course not. Paul taught that the people in the Corinthian church were keeping themselves on spiritual milk, not learning to digest the meat of Scripture. Paul told them they were keeping themselves spiritual infants by not studying God's word and maturing in their faith. Are you a follower of Jesus? If you are, great. Are you drinking milk or learning to digest the meat of Scripture? Read God's word, study God's word, and pray for the Holy Spirit to help you grow and mature in your understanding. Open your Bible. You'll meet God and Jesus inside.
Hello, I'm Rocksteady. Welcome to everyone's favorite game show, What's a Turtle? It's the game show where we ask our contestants to tell us what is a turtle? Everlasting. I will read two different choices and our contestants will have to tell us which is a turtle. Allow me to introduce our three contestants. First, we have Daniel Sanchez. From Cypress, Texas. Daniel, I understand that you go to Cypress Christian School.
Yes, sir.
Next, we have Leslie King, also from Cypress. And I understand that you go to Hamilton Middle School. Welcome.
Thank you, Rock.
And lastly, we have Charles Jetson from Los Angeles, California.
Yes, Charles Jetson III, actually. I'm really too busy to be on game shows, but my media consultant suggested I make an appearance to be more accessible, likable, average Joe kind of stuff. I'm a billionaire, you see, and I own many companies in half of LA. I'm surprised you haven't heard of me.
Welcome, Charles. It's clear you haven't seen our show before.
No, of course not. I've been busy making millions.
Alrighty then. Let's jump right in. I will read two choices. And you will tell me which one has eternal value.
What is eternal?
Eternal. Value. Everlasting. Beyond this world.
What?
I think you'll get it as we go along. Let's begin with Daniel. Daniel, here are your two choices. Playing video games or helping a friend with his homework. Which has eternal value? What's eternal?
Helping a friend with homework has eternal value.
Absolutely correct. And now we go to Leslie. Winning an argument or forming a friendship. What's eternal?
I think that forming a friendship is eternal. That way I can support my friend and be there for them. I can tell them about Jesus if they don't already know. That's way more important than winning an argument.
Yes, Leslie. Choosing relationship over bragging rights for winning an argument is the right choice. Mr. Jetson, what has eternal value? Becoming famous or raising a loving family?
Becoming famous, baby. I'll be remembered long after I'm gone. I've built an empire.
Oh, Mr. Jetson, raising a family has eternal value. And becoming famous, it's fleeting in this world. And sometimes one can become famous for some very sad reasons.
That's right, Dad. Don't you hear him? Like, Mr. Steady's right. Why can't a dad just go home and spend time with his son?
I'm sorry. Who are you?
I'm Charles Jetson IV. I'm his son.
Son, now is not the time.
When is it the time, then? When?
Let me just take this interruption to say good day and thank you for joining us for What's Eternal?
Looking for insurance? No, not that kind. What we all need is the true assurance of Jesus. Want security? We can be secure in Jesus' promises. We need to remember who we are in Christ and build our lives on a firm foundation, on the rock, Jesus. Jesus is eternal. When we build our lives on Jesus and His Word, it is like building a house on a rock foundation. The storms of this life will not take it down. We don't want to build our lives on the fleeting, temporary ideas of this world. That would be like building a house on sand. When the storms of life come, it won't remain standing.
where no one can lay any foundation other than the one already laid, which is Jesus Christ. 1 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 11. More like him. I hope you think about what you can do this week to grow to know him more. And in the meantime, we'll see you next week, and thanks for joining us.